Welcome to the AESOP Vehicle Retrieval System. Welcome to the AESOP Vehicle Retrieval System. Please visit us.
All right, Steven, you have the Mantis. Kel, you have the Sentinel, so everyone else, I guess, can fall on me on
Welcome
the colorless black.
Welcome to the AESOP Vehicle Retrieval System. Vehicle selected.
Now.
Stand by.
Hangar.
Your vehicle has been delivered to the following location.
Alright, Hangar 14 for all the bad guy squad. Putting cargo in it. Oh crap, I forgot. So we gotta figure out a way to win. Well, I guess we will consider, once we down everyone on the cargo team, I guess we'll consider that a win. If there's nobody to fight you, then we won, right? So we'll do that. So kind of an attrition match, but yeah, that'll work. Because originally I was going to have like either two ballistas or like a couple STBs or something in the C2. And if you drove those off, then you won. But it's kind of hard to get vehicles into the Caterpillar. Y'all are free to attack us as much as you like. So our job is to disable you, so... if we blow you up, we fail. Outside of that, no, you can shoot us. If you want to jump out your ship and go EVA and shoot us as we're coming in, that's fair. Basically, anything goes as long as you're not cheating. Did y'all want to go ahead and drop down to Alpha? Just the cargo team. Get on now, get. Caterpillar specifications. so it looks like the top speed on the cat is not that fast. Shield, same as the C2. It's, yeah. Wow, its top speed is 894. That's super slow. I believe it's just those three. Wait, space. Are you on the cargo team? Okay, awesome. If you could jump down to Alpha, that'd be great. We're gonna talk about how to kill y'all. Uh-oh. Get out of here, Connick. Are you you just supervising Connick? Are you gonna join? Until the shields are down, and then go ahead and relax off of it. So don't shoot after the shields are down if you're using regular weapons. But the regular weapons will definitely help us get through the shields, so we can start slapping EMPs on the cat. Use it at least inside of 700 meters as well. You want to be real close to him. Yeah. If you can do 500 meters, I don't know if Apple's going to like make it easy for us or not. Yeah. Yeah. Well, the cat is a very slow, not very maneuverable ship, so. Disabled, all you have to do is keep charging the MP, keep hitting it. So, but we'll just kind of skip that. unless they start acting funky, but then we'll just keep hitting them with the EMPs. Takes a little bit of fiddling with. Just get close to me and Von Kell, and then we're gonna get in position. I'm gonna be right back. I'm gonna check and see if they're ready. Hello? Hey. Should. Are y'all ready? Okay. So are y'all jumping from OM1 to Daymar and then back? So you're going to be jumping back to Kirill 1. Gotcha. Okay, then we will jump to Daymar OM1 and jump to Kirill 1 from there, and then we'll head. Yeah, we'll head back and we'll stop actually somewhere. Yeah, that'll work. Okay, yeah, so that's what we'll do. We're gonna jump to Daymar, OM1, face Kirill 1, jump that way, and then stop somewhere in between. And then that's where we're set up the trap. Yeah, Daymar, OM1 to Kirill. Yeah, that'll work. Awesome. I'll jump over. Alright, got some clarification. So everyone jump to Daymar, OM1, and then we are going to jump to Kirill 1 from there and stop in the middle. So I'm actually going to make a... I'm going to head that way now. Thank you. should be able to set your jump points to me after you get to Daymaro. Everyone on the pirate side needs to spawn or QT to one shot. I'm in between Daymaro 1 and Cruel 1. So once y'all are ready, they're currently going to Daymaro 1 and they're going to warp to us. We're going to catch them in the middle using the Mantis. And as soon as we get a blip, we're just going to put that ship down, basically. We don't want to blow it up, but we're gonna knock out his shields, disable it using the EMP from the Sentinel, and then board it. Distortions? Well, we'll just double check, and if we start seeing that the hole is going red, real nasty, then we'll make an adjustment, and I might just ask Apple to just pretend he's disabled or something. Next patch, we won't actually have to do distortion weapons. We can just blow them up, take our chances with the 70-30 split of maybe they'll die, maybe they won't, and then take what we can get from there. It's probably how most pirates are gonna run it, but for now, we'll just see. Kill, you're 6,000 meters from me. Steven, do you have your distortion up? You have to apply it. You gotta so turn on the you should be able to turn it on. Can you turn your screen on? I mean, sorry. It is? Oh yeah, we're good. Okay, cool. Indefinitely until you turn it off or get blown up. Alright, I'm gonna push it closer to y'all. As soon as we see some blips, that should be. Make sure to keep that Mantis about, you don't need to be super close to him, so if you could get close and put some damage on him, that'd be great.
If not,
no worries, just make sure to keep him shut down. eyes on your radar. Okay. They said they had an AFK. I'm gonna sneak in a quick piss. Yeah, they're about to launch. Yeah, I'm back. Never. En route. 20. Right side. Oh no, he just turned red because he pulled someone out. We got contact, Got him. On me. How close are y'all? How close is the Mantis on? Okay. Keep launching missiles. I don't have any left. Alright, we're gonna can't get away with it. Need to lighten this up. Someone in the co-pilot seat? Okay, I'm gonna need you, no, put power to shields. If you're gonna be a co-pilot, I need you to work. Okay, then hop out. Oh, no worries, no worries. Shields are almost down. Once that front shields go down, I need you to hit them with an EMP. EM's still up. It's not turned off yet. Technically, that'd be a loss. We keep trying to shut them down, though. Okay, so I have a Harbinger with all distortion weapons on it. What were you, Von Kill, what weapons did you have? Did you have ballistics? Gotcha, gotcha, okay. Did you want to switch to the, switch ships? So I can fly the Sentinel, and then you can fly the Cutlass, and I'm decent in PvP with the Sentinel. I'll definitely be able to show them out. No, yeah, they want to. Yeah, round one goes to Apple. Okay, well, let's try and... We gotta get the Mantis back, so let's link back up to Cruel One and we'll restart it. Yeah, yeah, we almost got that front face. I was like, oh, if we get that down and we hit it, it's over. Yeah, it was very close. Right. Advice. Yeah, and your weapons are no joke. They were eating me up. Yeah. Size fours. All of a sudden I saw something pop and I was like, ah, there it goes. yeah, that's fine. Yeah, we could just go through the process from there. Steven, are you coming back? I brought him back home. Yeah, yeah, we can still do it. If y'all want to jump to OM1 again and just set up real quick, and then we'll I think we just gotta get the Mantis back. And then swap out. We're gonna make a couple adjustments real quick. And then, we'll go from there. Okay. Yeah, this is all a learning process for a lot of us. I've actually never done any board action, so I didn't really know how this was going to work out. But this kind of tells me that pirate organizations that do this kind of stuff are going to be really organized. Gotcha, gotcha. Yeah, yeah, no, no. Right, right. Yeah, I mean, we almost got that front shield down. If we get one shield face and an EMP on it, that's shutting you down. So we were right there from shutting you down. So if we just had the Mantis stay back a little bit more, what we were having a problem is getting that shield down. So I think we were all in the same mindset of, like, just everyone pile on. But since the Mantis is so squishy, we probably just got to keep that, you know, 5K away, 7K away. And, that way we can keep you there, because as soon as that popped, it was like, yeah, y'all dipped out like you should have. I was actually proud of that. Yeah, that's not a bad run. Not a bad first run.
Please proceed to assigned landing bay.
We gotta go through this process and just, you know, figure it out, practice. It's like doing a raid. You know, like the first time you run it, it's gonna be rough. That's why I didn't do it. Von Kelar, do you want to swap? Oh, gotcha. My bad. We've been all the way to the station. Yeah, no, you're right. Everybody back to Anchor 7. You're staying on the Cutlass. Me and Vaughn are gonna swap because I'm pretty familiar with PvP and Sentinel. So he's gonna pilot the Cutlass, and y'all are gonna basically do the same thing. Y'all are gonna be on standby for the FPS action. Yeah. Right. No, like there is no. This is a judgment-free zone. Like. We're all learning together. Yeah. Though that's you know, we're not gonna be doing. We're practicing this to see how people are gonna attack us, right? Yeah. So.
Thank you, and please visit again.
I'm curious about it. I'm gonna save my Wait, are we missing someone in the colors? Oh, you're in the turret. There you go. But yeah. That Mantis, so he gets close and he gets lit up by them size fours, man. That thing goes. Jeez. Yeah, I do miss the cat. I feel like a lot of people don't give it love. And it's one of my favorite cargo ships just because it looks like a cargo ship. It feels like a cargo ship. The C2 doesn't feel like that.
He just popped out of system.
I may have accidentally started the EMP already. I don't want to have enough money that much, man. Yeah. I don't even see it. I've seen pictures and I'm like, yeah, I bet it looks better in game. Ugh. Black and gold. It's gonna be even better with the rework too. Yeah, go ahead. I'm setting the spot now. Thanks. Alright, this time we're fucking this shit. Yeah, you can do them with mouse and keyboard. You just gotta train with it. But it's an off and on switch. Yeah, all right, everyone jump to one shot. All right. once we get it disabled, we're all gonna hop out and board it, since we don't have to technically worry about them powering back up. Generally, I would probably have to stay in the Vanguard and keep pumping the EMPs, yeah. Which is why a lot of pirate groups prefer the Warlock, because the Warlock actually has one of the fastest EMPs. Fastest for the amount of damage it does. The Raven is technically the fastest, but its power isn't there. If we can't do it with this one, we may need to get a few more ships. So next round, like, we don't succeed. Yeah. Konik, we need you. It's cold in space. Let's all huddle for warmth. I'm waiting on the call. No, they're gonna call it. You actually go red on our screen. So as soon as like your icon, yes, I don't know if there's another indicator, so definitely try and look for one and see. But as soon as like you go red, that's we know we pulled some. Would it be funny is if we actually, so if we actually pull out another player that is not Apple, do not engage them. As much as I want to, we're not actual pirates in this org, so we just gotta let them go. Just got the message. All right. They said they're en route, so they're jumping now. Yeah, there does need to be some kind of indicator to see where you pulled them out from. See nothing yet. I feel like we should oh shit. Someone wants to buy railguns for $175,000 a pop? What? Yeah. Okay, they said they just jumped. Yep. Just turned red. We got them. Scanning. There they are. Right side. See him, yep, got him. Merging on him. He's on full speed, everybody get on him. Keep that Mantis about 5,000-7,000 out from him. Gonna pop the EMP. Got him. No, me. It's all good. We gotta hit him again. I gotta adjust the damn screens. I can't see much stuff. Pound them with missiles. Shit, I just... Oh, crap, my bad. Missile. coupled is not working for us. I need to go ahead and put everyone that's not in a ship in a ship to be able to do this. Down, everyone hit it. Everyone hit it, even Mantis. Get that shield down. Did we get it? Keep hitting it. Shut it down. It's shutting up. It's okay. It's okay. We hit them once, their EM is coming down. So once the CMP can get charged again, I'll be able to hit him again. It's okay. MV5As and the 85B, it's just not gonna work. I'm gonna have to switch over to the Harbinger. And then someone hold on. I'm gonna bring him up. No, yeah, we're just leave him alone. Hey, we're actually gonna pause because we don't have enough like distortion damage to be able to take you out. We really gotta have dedicated distortion. So what I'm thinking is you know, kind of leave it where it's at, let us go rearm and set up right, and then, because the Mantis doesn't have distortion weapons on it either, right? Yeah, yeah, we could just, yeah. Yeah, it's just we don't have enough distortion damage from all the other ships. Yeah, no, the problem is that we need every ship to have distortion weapons. That's the issue right now. We're getting the shield down, we're getting the EMP, we're dropping his EM, but we're not applying the additional distortion damage because the other ships don't have, like, but yeah, we'll just, for the sake of it, we'll say that y'all won round two, and then this is gonna be round three, we'll go into, like, that piece. Sound good for everyone? This is very dedicated stuff. So, the Vanguard having like the 85B and the MVSA is like, it's not going to cut it when it comes to distortion damage for the components. So I think, yeah, we really need, either. Well, and I noticed that the EM was coming down on the Caterpillar pretty good, but we needed the like additional distortion damage from the weapons. And we can't apply it with Apple being as good as a pilot as he is. Okay, so we're going to pretend we don't suck. And y'all could go back into Alpha. Because y'all had me red. I was about to die. I was like, oh man, I'm about to die. Like... And that was also my bad. I didn't call when I was about to launch the EMP so you can get away. So you were right on him. So yeah, a couple mistakes. This is very much a coordinated effort. Yeah, right. That's what I mean. A little bit of incorrect commands. But all right, so we're gonna exit our ship and y'all can jump in Alpha again. Prepare to be boarded. Okay. Okay, y'all, we're gonna go in from the front. Oh, wait, did the front door open? What? Did he open it? It's a trap. Okay, come to the side. Or exit out EVA and then come to the side. Yes, man. I'm opening the door. There you go. It's now opening up. So we're probably gonna have to go underneath from the elevator. They're not in the cockpit. Yeah, I see him. He just left. No. Yeah, we gotta go through the elevator. Elevator door's opening. Tupperware. Not sure. Down them, yeah, just down them. Coming in with you, Aiden. Three down? Are you already in set? He did it, but listen, I am dead. Yeah, pick him up. Reaper, you're not even in the party. I don't see him in the party at all. Oh, wait, no, he's no-no, right? Duh, I can see. Okay, wait, I want to see where you came in. Thank you. Oh, gotcha. So you you hit the catwalk, basically. Right, right, right. Oh, I missed it. Gotcha. Gotcha, gotcha. Being a little cheeky boy. Which one? Oh, maybe. Yeah, let me check. Oh, Steven Gamer, my bad, bro. Oh my gosh, you're still down. I didn't yell at us. I just picked him up. I got him, I got him. Next time, throw something. Jeez. Alright, let's see. Let's see if we can, ow. Back up a little bit. Back up, back up. Too many times because the other doors took like two shots. Yeah. Yeah, I tapped that door that you went through that the Vanguard's pointing at. I actually used the railgun here. See, I just opened up. If y'all want to see it in action, y'all can come over to reset, and then I'll shoot another one of the doors. But it's like the fastest way to get in the door. So I'll shoot this one to the left of Steven. I'm so sorry. Oh my gosh. Oh no. My bad. Let me show you how to open this door real quick. I was. It is very open. Oh, man. I'm sorry. Well, the good news is that we got a box out of it. Did it? Yeah, all that. It's like, let me just open this door real quick. Nope. Yeah, we're still here, so if you need to come back and get your stuff, we'll wait. Pirate's got a pirate. Dang, that was crazy. If you start making that, it will not be hard, okay? I promise. Okay. Let's try this. Is it? Really? That's crazy. If anybody needs armor or guns replaced because of that, please let me know. and I'll send you it, or, you know, send you the credits or whatever, because I did not think I was. Well. Yeah. Have a good one, and thank you for joining the event. Yeah. Hey, we learned something, so. No worries. Really, we needed like two more ships. But that's, you know, that's what we would want to expect. So that is the. No, yeah, gotcha. I rescue, yeah. Oh no, 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 no. Oh, okay, you're right here. Oh god. I thought like I thought you glitched outside the ship. Oh no, railgun, that is not what I wanted to do. But yeah, I just wanna say, like, nobody sucks here, none of that. Like, we all learned this process together. And I think this just goes to show that not set up and experienced, that this kind of stuff's gonna be hard, and most likely, just with this testing, I'm pretty sure that everyone's just gonna want to use like a retaliator or Eclipse and just blow you up. if all of a sudden you got, you know, five ships on you doing this stuff, you probably can bet that they're a Byronorg that's pretty efficient. Look at this Mustang. It looks like it wants a railgun shot. No, no, you think you could take a railgun shot? No. Can't see it. Sorry about that, y'all. If y'all needed any guns replaced or armor and stuff, let me know. I can find it on the market and I'll replace it for you. Just send me a message. Oh yeah, true. Thank you. Yes. Stay there. I'm gonna show you something real quick. So you know how you can like fly into people and get them to glitch into the ship? You can do the same thing with the shark. Doesn't want to let me do it anymore. Nice. I will bring the box over to you. Be right back. this and... I'm not gonna lie though, I did kind of enjoy it. They're like, how is he flying so good in a caterpillar? I could tell. Yeah, but no, I mean, people aren't gonna make it easy for us, so that's what it's gonna take to really kind of do that stuff. So because this role is death. I guess we could go ahead and call it on that one. I want to go do some other stuff. We can do that. Really didn't. Say what? Oh, gotcha. I forgot. Okay, sorry, y'all. Okay. Have a good one. Learned all the ways on how to not board a ship that you want to take over. Super secret, and have I heard of them? Yeah, but I get in trouble if I say it out loud. That's too sus. That's too sus for me. I got too many people saying this guy's a good guy. Ash and Nova. He's asking me to load up the merchandise first and then take payment. I always take payment either half up front, or I give half the merchandise and then get half, you know, half the payment. Yeah, I almost always do, but let's see. Make sure. Yeah, basically. And I'll always send proof. Ooh, this guy is with Executioner's Viper Squadron, 31st Caliban Armored Squadron, and Eternal Hawk Empire. And he is a captain and a major, two of those. I don't like him. He's been playing the game. He's only recently started playing the game. Okay, he agreed to at least half, so worst case, I lose 5 railguns. No problem.
Welcome to the vehicle selected. Stand by.
He won't be able to because I transfer everything through a C2 and armistice zone. So the only thing he can do is steal the 5 railguns. But if he does anything, I can close the door on him. So when he looks in it, if he takes longer than like 15 seconds,
your vehicle has been delivered to the following location.
Since he won't be in the party, he won't be able to open it back up, and that'll actually cancel him out. So that's basically what I have in the C2, because the C2 has the storage containers that you can open up that act as those like 1SU boxes. Yeah, that's what I used to transfer the Rogan Sayo, so basically I use that same thing. Oh yeah. No, there's no accidentally taking too many, that's for sure. You'll get blacklisted with me real quick. I do. There's also the, yeah. The arms dealing put me over that side of nerd stuff. I actually had a good time. I met up with a friend I haven't talked to in a while. He was like, "So what you been up to?" And I'm like, "Oh, I'm just the..." What did I say? I said it in the goofiest way possible. I was like, "I'm just the arms dealer for the North American branch of the military for a gaming org." And he just kind of looked at me and took a sip out of his drink. It was great. But he's the guy that sits there and, you know, likes bugs. He has a butterfly collection. I'm like, "You can't talk. You literally pay money. You pay money to have something in a cage and then have it die." Because I don't know if y'all know about butterflies, but they don't live long. Are any of y'all still on the server? Are y'all at Cruel One? Say that again. What's 175k? Okay, so cool, 2 million. So it needs to send me like 900. Hello, hello. Welcome to One Shot Resets Armory.
Hey, how you doing?
Doing well, doing well. It's going to be the open storage container right in front of us.
Cool. Sounds good.
Yeah, once you verify the merchandise, I got 5 more for you. If you can transfer the credits, that'd be great.
Yeah, so. All right.
Looks like we're gonna be good. I almost start talking in game. Yeah, I think it's transferring the credits. Yep.
My bad. That was 175,000.
Awesome. I'll put the rest in.
I just have the rest.
Awesome, thank you much. Everything look good? Making the steel real quick.
Looks perfect, good sir.
Awesome. You got everything?
Yep, I got them all moved. Thank you very much.
Yeah, go ahead and add me. We do these deals often.
Yeah, I try to buy in bulk, so I appreciate that you had 10.
Yeah, I couldn't get the approval on selling them all because we have inventory for our order. But as we gather them up, we'll be getting rid of the surplus.
Yeah, no, I've probably got I don't know, close to like 80 that I've been collecting for my org, but I'm still trying to, you know, work on more just to distribute. I'm the quartermaster, so I fucking have to just keep collecting them all the time.
Gotcha, awesome. Well, I'll make sure to keep you in mind. I'll let you know whenever I got a good inventory because I'm the arms dealer for my org.
Cool. Perfect. Sounds good, man.
All right, you have a
good one. Hope to have a good friendship.
Yes, sir.
You too.
Is this UIO? Oh, okay. Ooh, this scared me. I was like, who is this random? Nope, successful sell. Sorry, I'm back. Yeah. Trade is done. Railguns. For 170,000 a pop. Or 175. This time I actually just happened to have a surplus. I got lucky and found like, I don't know, like 15 last week. On top of, I think Magnus gave me 2 mil to buy a bunch of them. And I got them for like 125K a piece plus a couple grenade launchers and missile launchers on top of it. So that was a very profitable. I mean, I basically made 50K off each railgun. Sell for 100. I mean, I usually negotiate down to 100K, 125. But like this guy, he said he's a quartermaster for his org, and he has a stock of about like 80 railguns. I thought that was kind of crazy, but proximity chat, so if you're close enough you'll be able to hear it. Pretty good for me.